Everyone's facing the same issue. There's a system that's oppressing us and we need to speak up against it.
You're fighting for black unity. Doesn't this make you an anti-white group? Do you feel anti-white?
No, we're anti-white racists.
You know, the in-your-face racism that we were experiencing when we were growing up, it expressed itself in your face, out there, loud and proud. Now, it's covert, and it expresses itself in prejudice, and in discrimination, and stereotyping, and even walking into a shop and you're profiled already, you know.
When I saw them, I was just awestruck again because they're people like us. And it's always just really inspiring knowing that one day we could be like them, because it's not like they're Kanye. It's not something so far away. And they were once like us, 16, 17-year-olds fighting for change.
There was no human rights for our people, you know, and being harassed by the police. Do you boys then know what your legal rights are if a policeman comes and hassles you? If a policeman stops and asks you a question, check out what his number is.
In South Auckland, we have all the stereotypes in the world. So it's nice to know that people that literally were the first generation of New Zealand Pacific born, and they've brought up to have that look, to question our values, to question how the government is teaching us, and to question institutional racism. If you went there, there were no Balang people whatsoever. So it was like literally just a whole bunch of brown kids trying to make a difference. But like there was barely any support from like any other cultures, which was like really shocking for a country and a city who all went to go support Black Lives Matter. And who, like, so many people went to go support that. But as soon as like a bunch of kids literally want to fight for community issues, it's all of a sudden a different matter,
yeah,
to talk about.
Everyone talks about how multicultural we are and there's so much community here, but then when it comes to community issues, they're gone.
I think it's important for us to learn the histories of our people, and with history we do teach that, but we also teach like world history as well. And so with Pacific Studies we focus more on the histories of our people, of our community, but also we look at issues like the gender pay gap, and that Pasifika woman at the bottom of this gender pay gap, and we also look at climate change in the Pacific, and we focus on issues that affect our community and in a way that empowers our students to fight against those issues and to raise awareness around these issues so that we can contribute to making our community better.
In a way, we're helping the establishment correct itself before revolution develops. You see, we believe in a revolution, but at the moment we feel that the revolution in New Zealand would be a social revolution without being a violent revolution. And it's up to the establishment to wake up. And now the Panthers are just sort of a group to wake up the establishment. And if they don't wake up, then we stick to the definition of the Panther animal, which we attack and wipe out their aggressor.
It's kind of revolutionary because we're changing their mindsets. They come into our talk and, you know, and they're learning so much in that short time that you can see them trying to think about, what can we do in our hood, what a neighbourhood.
Racism is a massive issue. Like Black Lives Matter, it was Ihumatu, it was the Christchurch, and we're all getting together a lot more. And I think that's the next chapter of Polynesian Panthers. Polynesian Panthers is literally Polynesian Panthers. But we're not saying just Polynesian anymore. We might as well just be the Panthers now. Yeah. And I think that's it. That's the next chapter.